Hello people, in this video we want to specifically focus on a particular orbital infection called as the orbital cellulitis. Okay, so this one is an emergency and hence we need to understand it. So first of all, let us understand what orbit is. So orbit is the cavity, right, in the skull where the eye is there, right? So that is the orbit. So this will be the orbit. So they are talking about orbital infections. Right, under orbital infections, they have a preseptal cellulitis, orbital mucormycosis, cavernous sinus thrombosis. So we are focusing basically to understand the septal, preseptal and all that, okay. So preseptal is also called as periorbital. So basically when you see here, we need to understand what this preseptal and postseptal is. So basically where is the orbital septum? Here you can see the orbital septum. Are you able to see guys the orbital septum? Superior, inferior, both they have marked here. So basically any infection in front of this will be preseptal cellulitis or so it is called as periorbital. Okay, so this is what? Preseptal, right? This is preseptal cellulitis, or it is also called as peri, that is around periorbital, right? Is this clear? So this is preseptal. Now where will postseptal be? That will be here. So postseptal is nothing but the orbital cellulitis, okay? So which is the emergency? Emergency is this one, okay? The orbital cellulitis, that is the postseptum, that is behind the septum, okay? So have you understood the difference between preseptal cellulitis? Okay, this is preseptal cellulitis here, and this one here in the red is the postseptal cellulitis, or simply called as the orbital cellulitis. This is the emergency orbital cellulitis. Okay, this one is an emergency. Okay, what they are saying here is this never involves the globe. The globe is not involved, but the surrounding structures are involved, right? So from the anterior view, you can see that this is the orbital septum here, marked here, orbital septum, right? So what is this? This is the superior tarsus and this is the inferior tarsus, eyelid, okay? So in orbital infections, you have the preseptal cellulitis, orbital cellulitis, orbital mucormycosis, cavernous sinus thrombosis. Here we want to just try to understand what exactly these terminologies, preseptal, postseptal, are. Now, preseptal cellulitis is also called as periorbital cellulitis. It refers to the infection of the subcutaneous tissue anterior to the orbital septum. So, where is the infection? It is anterior to the orbital septum. And what is affected here? The subcutaneous tissue. How is it affected? There is infection, right? There is infection. So, basically, this is not, strictly speaking, this is not an orbital disease, they are saying. It is included here because the facial veins are valveless and preseptal cellulitis may spread posteriorly to produce orbital cellulitis. So the problem with this preseptal cellulitis is, though it is technically, they are not saying it is an orbital disease, it can spread and become an orbital cellulitis. How will it spread? Posteriorly. When it goes posteriorly, the preseptal can become orbital cellulitis. So this can become orbital cellulitis. How? By spreading. Okay. Next, what is the cause? Etiology of this preseptal cellulitis. Standard things you will write: Staphylococcus, Streptococcus, those bacteria, right? So bacteria like Staphylococcus, Streptococcus, Haemophilus influenzae, etc. How does this infection actually happen? This infection happens from exogenous infection, endogenous infection, local infection which got extended here. Okay, so what and all are the causes of this preseptal cellulitis? So how's it going people? We will look at the modes of infection of the preseptal tissue. Okay, so exogenous infection from skin laceration, insect bites, eyelid operations, it's coming from outside, exogenous, okay? Now what will be endogenous infection? Hematogenous spread, that is via blood, some remote infection of the middle ear or the upper respiratory tract. So from there, from inside through the blood it is coming, that is endogenous infection. And extension from local infection, some local infection like acute hordeolum, acute dacryocystitis, all this can lead to a pre-septal cellulitis. Okay, is this clear? So did you understand it is coming either from outside, insect bite, eyelid operation, skin laceration, etc. Inside, from ear, from upper respiratory infection via the blood it is coming, hematogenous spread. Extension from local infections means like acute hordeolum, acute dacryocystitis. Okay. So then, what are the clinical features of preseptal cellulitis? Let's look at the clinical features. Clinical features of preseptal cellulitis. Okay. So do you understand this word cellulitis? Itis is what? Inflammation. Inflammation of these cells. Okay. So this subcutaneous tissue which is there in front of the septum. That's what we are talking about, right? We are talking about what? Preseptal cellulitis. So some problem here. As it is not an emergency, we can use a better color. What do you say? Right? So something here. Okay. So basically, how will this patient present? Clinical features will be inflammatory edema of the eyelids. So the eyelids will be swollen. Inflammatory edema of eyelids, right? Inflammatory edema of eyelids, periorbitals and periorbital skin with no involvement of orbit. That is what is important here. Here the orbit is not involved. They are saying it is technically not the orbit which is infected. Okay, it is in front of the orbit. So let's go back here. Periorbital skin and no involvement of orbit. So what will be the features? Okay, let's look at that. Okay, so here what will be the clinical features? You yourself can say, now you can see there is inflammation, edema of eyelids and the skin. What skin? Periorbital skin around the orbit. The skin also has, you can see, edema, right? So here there will be painful acute periorbital swelling. You can see painful acute sudden, right? Painful it is, or periorbital swelling is there. Erythema, hyperemia of the lids, fever, leukocytosis, proptosis is absent. Okay, so there is something here they are saying proptosis is absent. Ocular movements are normal. This person can move the eye. Conjunctiva is usually not congested. Visual acuity is normal. So these are kind of important features you should know here. Okay. So what and all they are saying? There is a painful, yes, there is pain. Okay. Painful swelling is there. But they are saying the ocular movements are normal. Right. The movements of the eye are normal. Conjunctiva not congested. Okay. Visual acuity is normal. Vision is fine. Proptosis is absent, so there is no proptosis, protrusion of eye is not there. Okay, that's what they are saying here. Then fever is there, leukocytosis, definitely it's an infection, so you can guess, right? Infection means there will be fever, leukocytosis, that means the WBC count has gone high. Erythema, yes, there is some redness, hyperemia of the lids, right? So you can see that everything is very concerned with only the lids. The eye part is fine, right? The orbit part, the eyeball part of it looks fine, right? Okay, what is the treatment here? Let's complete it with treatment. Okay, so what will this person get? This person has infection, bacteria, Streptococcus bacteria, Staphylococcus bacteria, Haemophilus influenza, the bacteria. So what will you give? So basically you will give them some antibiotics. So here they are saying systemic antibiotics they will give, right? Because the infection can be coming from inside, outside, local infection. So basically they are saying systemic antibiotics, mainstay of the treatment, right? What will they give? Co-amoxiclav, that is amoxicillin plus clavulonic acid. Then they will give Fluoxacillin. So they're talking about these as oral drugs, okay? So you will have to look at the dose and all that in the textbook. Then severe cases, they will need hospitalization, guys, so that you can give them IV ceftriaxone. So in severe cases, you will have to give them IV antibiotics, so they will need hospitalization, okay? Ceftriaxone. What is ceftriaxone? So it's a third generation cephalosporin, if you have seen our video. There we have ceftriaxone. It's also used against typhoid, right? So that is the drug, ceftriaxone. Remember with this tree, ceftriaxone, tree zone. It's a zone of tree. Ceftriaxone, right? It's a third generation cephalosporin. So it is active against gram-negative bacteria also, they are saying. So here it will tackle Haemophilus influenzae also. What is this amoxiclav? That is clavulanic acid with amoxicillin, right? So basically this is a extended spectrum penicillin, right? Extended spectrum, semi-synthetic penicillins. When it comes to cloxacillin, they are saying it is narrow spectrum penicillin, okay? And then here they are also suggesting analgesics, guys, to relieve pain, analgesics, anti-inflammatory drugs, okay? So to reduce this swelling. Then they are also suggesting warm compress, so to have a soothing effect, and then surgical exploration. So if there is some mass or abscess, or if some foreign body is there, they are also considering surgery, okay? Warm compress and surgical exploration if there is foreign body or abscess or some mass, okay guys? So basically this is it about preseptal cellulitis. That's all we had to cover about preseptal cellulitis. Remember, the emergency is which one? The orbital cellulitis, that is the postseptal. So this one itself can become, this one can spread posteriorly and it can become orbital cellulitis. So we need to understand if it is orbital cellulitis and we have to handle immediately. So let's understand the post-orbital cellulitis. We have to be able to differentiate, right? This is the main thing. It is also called as intra-orbital abscess, right? Orbital cellulitis. So basically here in orbital cellulitis, how will you know? Here basically there will be proptosis, okay? So here they are talking about proptosis. So this is orbital cellulitis. So they are talking about proptosis. Basically what happens in orbital cellulitis is that the post-septal tissue is affected, right? So there is infection, acute infection of the soft tissue of the orbit behind the orbital septum. So basically here again there are the same things, exogenous infection, extension from neighboring structures, endogenous infection, same streptococcus, staphylococcus, Haemophilus influenzae, same bacteria. So basically why does this happen? Because the orbit doesn't have any lymphatics, okay? So there is rapid spread, necrosis. So this damage is rapid, it's extensive because it's a tight compartment, right? It is somewhere, you know where, it is there in the skull, right? So it's a tight compartment, so the damage becomes rapid and extensive. So you definitely need to address this very soon. This is an emergency. So here, what will the symptoms be? Swelling, definitely you can see the swelling, severe pain, right? And this pain, basically, it is increased with the movements of the eyeball, okay? So this is the main symptom, they are saying pain with the movement. Here all other things will be there, fever, etc. Vision loss, yeah, vision loss, diplopia, they are all will be there in the moderate to advanced disease. So it's better to catch it soon. Here axial proptosis, the protrusion of the eye also may be present. There'll be restricted ocular movements, okay. And then RAPD also may occur, that is, what is this? Relative afferent pupillary defect. And when you examine the fundus here, you may see congestion of the retinal veins, papilloedema, papillitis, okay? So look at these symptoms again. Swelling, yes, swelling of the lids, woody hardness and redness. So the swelling of the lids, how are they? Characterized by woody hardness, redness, okay? Then there is severe pain which is increased with the movement of the eyeball, right? General symptoms like fever, etc. Vision loss, diplopia can occur in the moderate to advanced cases. That's why you need to catch this early, right? Axial proptosis. So here proptosis, we are mentioning proptosis, right? Restriction of ocular movements, RAPD may occur. Fundus examination can show congestion of retinal veins, signs of papillitis, papilloedema, okay? And what they are saying here, conjunctiva, chemosis of conjunctiva, which may protrude and become desiccated or necroted. Desiccated is dry, right? Desiccated or necroted. Chemosis of conjunctiva. Okay. So why does this condition become so important? Because this can go into some complications, okay? Ocular complications, blinding, right? Exposure keratopathy, optic neuritis, central retinal artery occlusion, that is CRAO, right? All these can occur in these people. Or vital complications like subperiosteal or abscess. There could be abscess or vital abscess. Temporal or parotid abscess. That's the parotid gland they are talking about. The parotid abscess. Intracranial complications. Oh my God. General septicemia or pyemia may eventually occur in few cases. So it is just going to even systemic levels, not just blindness, right? What are the investigations you do in this, in these people? Blood culture, you will check the leukocytosis if it is there. You will do complete blood analysis, right? The CBC, complete hemogram, X-ray you can do, or CT scan, MRI, orbital ultrasonography. So basically with this you can find out if it is preseptal or postseptal. You can know if it has extended into the cranium, intracranial extension. If it is there, you can know of this orbital cellulitis, etc., etc., etc. Now, how will you treat this orbital cellulitis? Again, it is infection. Similar treatment only. Look at the treatment here. Oxacillin, ampicillin, cefotaxime, then ciprofloxacin, vancomycin. To cover the gram-negative, that is Haemophilus influenzae, they're talking about chloramphenicol, clavulanic acid. To cover anaerobic bacteria, they're saying oral metronidazole, analgesics to relieve pain, anti-inflammatory drugs to reduce the inflammation, topical antibiotics also can be given, topical antibiotics. Then what are they talking about? Nasal decongestant drops. Now that's interesting. You can give nasal decongestant drops, re-evaluation at least twice to thrice daily in the hospital. You should monitor the response and modify the treatment accordingly. Surgical intervention, indications include if it is unresponsive to antibiotics, if there is decreasing vision, or if there's an orbital or a subperiosteal abscess, then you can, what and all you can do, immediate canthotomy. What is this? Immediate canthotomy, cantholysis, canthotomy, cantholysis. So basically, if the orbit is tight and optic neuropathy is present, if severe, intraocular pressure is severely elevated, then what will you do? You will do canthotomy, cantholysis. So here they are saying canthotomy, some lateral canthen tendon they are going to surgically expose. Okay. Then free incision into the abscess so that you can drain this abscess, right? Then subperiosteal abscess is drained. You will do an incision right in the upper medial aspect. Please check all the details, more details from the textbook. Then in most cases they are saying it is necessary to drain both the orbit as well as the infected paranasal sinuses. So even the sinuses they will have to drain. Okay, paranasal sinuses. So that's all about orbital cellulitis. Hope you have understood now what this preseptal cellulitis means, what this postseptal or orbital cellulitis means. So we started off with orbital infections, right? We saw there is preseptal, orbital cellulitis, orbital mucormycosis, cavernous sinus thrombosis, which we have not gone details into those two. We are focusing on the septal things. So preseptal, you saw the image, okay? And you saw postseptal, that is orbital cellulitis. You understood what exactly orbit means. You understood what orbital septum is. Then preseptal cellulitis, how you can know whether it is preseptal, right? What the treatment is. Similarly, here we saw what antibiotics you will give, right? Warm compress, surgery, right? We saw all the treatment for preseptal cellulitis, right? We saw the treatment for preseptal, and then we saw the treatment for orbital cellulitis, similar treatment itself, right? What do you say? Some drug names have changed here though. Okay guys, that's all for now. Hope you have understood this topic, orbital infections. Bye bye.